An anole's throat flap appears for only a second or so and then vanishes. And its owner, after sending his message, returns to camouflaged obscurity. Another family of lizards living in the treetops has an even more varied repertoire of signals. They use not only gestures, but body colours. They're chameleons. Their stronghold is the island of Madagascar. And here there are over 60 different species of them, almost more than in all the rest of the world put together. This is a panther chameleon, and it's marvellously adapted for life among the branches. Its toes are divided into two bundles, three and two, and that means that it can use them just like forceps. Their grasping feet, supplemented by their gripping tail, enable them to become remarkable slow-motion acrobats. I suppose chameleons are best known for their ability to change colour, and that does help in camouflage, but actually they also use colour change as a way of communication and expressing their emotions. When a male panther chameleon spots a rival, he expresses his fury in glorious technicolor. Malawi, in Central Africa, may not have as many species of chameleon as Madagascar, but it has one of the largest, Mellor's chameleon, that can be 60 centimetres, nearly 2 feet, from nose to tail. Rival males, when they do battle, deploy a range of threats that is truly formidable. If signals don't deter, then they start to joust. It's not only males that fight, there are also battles between the sexes. This is the South African dwarf chameleon, a male in full courtship costume. This, somewhat less colourful, is a female. She is not welcoming his advances. As her mood darkens, so does her skin. she's driven him away. But why? There is a reason. She's pregnant. Her home, the South African Cape, can get quite cold. So instead of laying her eggs on the ground, as most chameleons do, she retains them within her body and warms them by seeking out the sunniest places and sunbathing. Now they're ready to emerge, alive. Producing babies in the branches might seem to be a risky business, but the membrane enclosing each one will stick to a twig if it hits one. And when at last the babies disentangle themselves, they immediately deploy their formidable chameleon grip. By the time they're properly dried out, the babies are as much at home in the branches as their mother. But for the most extraordinary chameleons of all, you have to look not up in the trees, but down here on the leaf litter. A whole range of species live on the ground, many of which have only recently been discovered. This is surely the most extraordinary of all chameleons. It's the pygmy leaf chameleon. This is a male, and he's fully grown, believe it or not. And yet, within this tiny little body, all the anatomical details of a normal-sized chameleon. What an extraordinary creature. Like all chameleons, it catches its food with its tongue. It eats tiny flies. Grasshoppers are popular with normal-sized chameleons. Contains a tapered rod encircled by muscle. As the muscle contracts, the tongue shoots forward off the rod. The tip physically grasps the prey, and then longitudinal muscles contract to pull the tongue back onto its rod, bringing the prey with it, which may weigh half as much as the chameleon itself. The whole action, in reality, is completed in a second or so. canopy of a tropical forest is full of food, and lizards clamber around looking for it in many ways. Chameleons use their toes to grip the twigs, and geckos use theirs to stick to leaves, for their toes have adhesive pads on the end.